Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent and the most merciful. Welcome you all again in the virtual learning system of Pakistan International School, Taif, Saudi Arabia. Dear students, as you know that this is Pakistan International School, Taif, virtual class for class second year students, subject computer science. And today is our 42 lecture. Teacher name Imran Ahmed. Dear students, as you know that in the previous lecture we were discussing write a program that will produce a table of equivalent temperature in both Fahrenheit and Celsius with an increment of pi from 50 to 100. Over there, there is initial value is 50 for Fahrenheit. And the last value for Fahrenheit is 100. And the increment is 5. So this was the program we already discussed in the previous lecture. Today our lecture is about write a program that prints the sum of the following sequence using for loop. Now we are bound over here. Program says using for loop. So you will not use the while loop or you will not use the do while loop as well. You must attempt this program with the help of for. Series is like this. Sum is equal to 30 plus 33 plus 36 plus 39 up to 60. Watch over here in the series. Initial value is 30 and the last value is 60. Initial value is 30 and the last value is 60. The increment between the two numbers is 3. Why 3? Because first value is 30, second is 33, third is 36, up to so on. Increment is 3. So keeping this series in mind, so we will have to develop the program. Hash include iostream.h starting header file, hash include conio.h void main. We have taken over here two variables. One is I for increment of the loop and sum we initialize with the value 0. After that clear screen, for watch there in the series and this one also. Series is first value is 30. Over here in the for, I started I is equal to 30. It means that initial value is 30 and the last value, watch over here, last value is 60. Last value is 60 and the increment between the two digits or the two numbers is 3. So we increase I plus equal to 3. So over here with the help of this statement, increment first value will be 30, then the second 33, then next will be 36, 39, 42 up to so on and the last value 60. Okay, sum is equal to sum plus I. Watch over here. First value of sum is 0. First value of sum is 0. So 0 plus 30. Value of I is 30. So it means that now sum having the value 30. Because watch here. It is in the block. And control will transfer to here. If the first value of I is 30. Next value will be 33. Why 33? Because over here the increment of is 3. So now 33 condition will be checked. 33 is less than 60, less than or equal to 60. Condition is 2. Control will be transferred to here. Before the execution of this one, sum having the value 30. Now 30 plus 33. 30 plus 33. Result will be 63. 30 plus 33. Result will be 63. Now sum having the value 63. Again, loop will be in increment over here. Control will be transferred to here. Now the value will be 36. 36 is less than 60. Condition is still true. Watch over here. 63 plus 36. What will be the result? So this process will be continue until the value of I becomes the 60. So when the value of I becomes 60, next time when it will increase the value of I. So value of I will be 63. Now 63 is less than or equal to 60, condition becomes false. When the condition becomes false, control will be transferred to this statement. Now sum having the value of last value of the sum is 495. After calculating, after the addition of all the numbers, sum having the value of which one? 495. So this message will be appear on the output screen, cout / n, sum of series is equal to, this is the message on the new line, because / n is the escape sequence for the new line. And value of sum over here, it store the value of sum is 495. So output should be like, look like this, sum of series is equal to 495. This will be the your answer. Keep in mind, in the paper point of view, you must show, if any program you have write attempt in the paper, so you must show the output as well. Get CH and termination of the main function. Over here, program will be finished. Next question, write the program. Next lab activity is write the program, above program using while loop. Same program, but using while loop. Now we are using the while loop. We will convert the for loop process into while loop. Same. So over here, this is small I, include iostream.h, hash include conio.h, void main, same two variable. First one is I, second is sum, and sum is initialized to zero. Clear stream, I is equal to 30. Watch here, in the for loop, we initialize the I variable inside the for loop. Watch here, this statement we place outside the for loop in the while loop. Okay, I is equal to 30. Oh, because while is only contain the condition, and condition is over here, I is less than or equal to 60. Next process is same, sum is equal to sum plus I after the addition, because over here in the for loop, after the process of this one, control comes to that statement. Now in the while loop, we write that statement after the sum is equal to sum plus I. So this statement is placed over here. It means that it will increase the value of I into 3 digits. Means if the first value of I is 30, the second value should be 33. This process will be continued as I explained in the previous question over here. Same process, same result. But the loop is changed. In the previous question, we do the same program with the help of for loop. Now we have to attempt, the same program with the help of while loop. After that, when the loop will becomes false, it means that when the value of I becomes 63, this condition will be false and control will be transferred over here, the same output statement. So result will be 495. Result is 495. Same process. Okay. Get CH and the termination of the main function. Next program. Write a program that prints all the positive odd numbers. Positive odd numbers up to 50. How many digits? Up to 50. Positive odd numbers, skipping those that are divisible by 5. Skipping those that are divisible by 5 using continue statement. Already we have studied the continue statement. Now over here, so it means that odd, first of all, you must know what are the odd numbers. Odd numbers are 1, 3, 5, 7. Those numbers which are not divisible by 2, they are called the odd numbers. So 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, up to 50 for last value will be 49. But one more requirement is over here. You will not display like 5. 5 is odd number, but in the output, 5 will be not displayed. Next, 15 will also not display it. 25, 35, 45. It means that those numbers, those odd numbers, which are divisible by 5, they will not display in that program with the help of continue statement. Hash include iostream.h, hash include conio.h, void main int I. So I is of type integer variable clear screen, first value of I is 1. Because it says up to 50, it means that we will start from positive 1, 3, 5, up to 50. So first value of I is 1. I is less than or equal to 50. Condition is true because I having the value 1, 1 is less than or equal to 50. Now over here, we apply the condition. Condition is like this. If I percent 5 is equal to 0. So over here, we write the statement continue. Now value of I is equal to 1, 1% 5. So this percentage operator provide us the remainder value. So 1% 5 remainder is 1. So 1 is equal to 0, condition becomes false. So when the condition becomes false, control will not transfer in the, over here, control will come to the else block. And in the else block, we write backslash t, it means that one tab, distance, escape sequence, and value of I is 1. So this one will be displayed. Next, this process, whole process is written in the for loop. It will increase I plus equal to 2, Y plus equal to 2, because if the first value is 1, then the next value should be 3, not a 2. Why 3? Because in the program, it says odd number. If the first value is 1, the second number should be 3. Now, 3 divided by 5 remainder. What is the remainder of this division? So, modulus operator provides us the division between the two integers. So, 3 is the remainder. 3 is equal to 0. Condition becomes false. Control will be transferred to here. And it will display the value of I. Value of I second time was 3. When the increment over here, now the value of I becomes 5. 5 is less than 50. Condition is true. Okay. Condition is true. If I percent 5 is equal to 0, check value of I is 5. 5 divided by 5, so remainder is 0. Now over here, 0 is equal to 0. Condition is true. Then this statement will become over here continue. It means that it will transfer the control for the next execution of the loop. Control will not come over here. So 5 will not display. Now the value of 5 will, now value of I should be 7. 7 divided, 7 is less than 50. Condition is true. Control comes over, transfer to here. 7% 5 remainder is 2. 2 is equal to 0. Condition becomes false. So control will not transfer over here. Control comes to the else statement. And this 7 should be displayed. Now this process will be continue on. And it will skip those numbers which are divisible by 5. So according to this process, according to that process, 1, 3, 5 will not display it. 7, 9, 11, 13, 15 will not display it. 17, next value 19, next value 21, next value 23. Now 25 is also an odd number, but 25 will not be displayed. Up to this process will be continue up to the last value of I should be 49. When the value of I becomes 51, when the value of I becomes 51, what happened? 51 is less than or equal to 50. Condition becomes false and control is transferred to over here. Control comes to transfer to over here and termination of the main function. Next program, write a program that reads an integer. Reads an integer and prints its factorial. First of all, you must know that what is the factorial process. Let's say I enter the number integer 4. The factorial of 4 is 24. What is the process over here? Why I say the factorial of 4 is 24? Because whenever we want to display the factorial of a number, so the process should be like this. If the number is 4, so 4 will be multiplied by the previous all numbers, previous numbers. So 4 multiplied by 3, multiplied by 2, multiplied by 1. So check it, 4 multiplied by 3, 12, 12 multiplied by 2, 24, and 24 multiplied by 1, 24. So the factorial of 4 is 24. Factorial of 3 should be 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1. So factorial of 3 will be 6. And the factorial of 5 should be 120. Factorial of 5 should be 120. So we will check and write the process. Hash is very, very important program. In mostly I saw this program in the board, federal board papers. So must try to practice these programs. Hash include iostream.h, hash include kanu.h. Void main. Over here, we take the three variables. I, n, fact, and we initialize the factorial variable with the value 1. So initially, factorial have the value 1. Clear screen, enter a number. Clear screen, enter a number. With the help of C in statement, we input a number. Let's say we input number 4 or 5, whatever you want to enter. So let's say we enter number 5. Now, n having the value 5. What should we have to do? Now the process will be start. So 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 1. So its answer should be 120. Now the process is over here. Excuse me. Okay, process is here for I is equal to 1. Initial value of I is 1. I is less than or equal to n. Value of n is 5. So 1 is less than 5, I plus plus. So 1 is less than 5. When the condition becomes true, control will be transferred to here. So 1 fact having the value 1. Watch here, factorial, this fact variable having value 1. So you can take the variable fact or f or whatever you want. So f fact is equal to fact multiplied by I. So next time, the value of fact is 1. It will increase the value I plus plus. It means that now the value of I becomes 2. 2 is less than 5 because n having the value 5 and value of I becomes now becomes 2. 2 is less than 5, condition is 2. So value of fact now will be 2 multiplied by 1. So now the value of fact should be 2. It will increase the value I becomes 3 now. 3 is less than 5, condition is 2. Value of fact having 2 and 2 multiplied by 3, 6. Now the value of fact is 6. So value of I will be increased. What should be the value? 4. 4 is less than 5, condition is 2. So 4 will be multiplied by 3. 4 threes are 12. Now the value of fact having, I think it having the value 4 multiplied by 12. So next time it will be, so it will be continue on and on until the value of I becomes 5. So value of I becomes, when the value of I becomes 5, what should be the 5 is less than or equal to 5, condition becomes 2. So this process will be going on. So it will lost value, the fact value having 120. So when the value of I become increased 6, 6 is less than or equal to 5, condition becomes false and control will be transferred to here after that block. After that block, control will be, when the condition becomes false, control will be transferred to over here. Keep in mind this cout containing the small letter cout, factorial of number. This message will be appear on the screen and the value of fact, last value of fact having 120, and it will display on the output screen. The output should be like this. Enter a number, it will ask, enter a number, and we enter a number 5. When we enter a number 5, factorial of number, this output statement will show you, this output statement will show you, factorial of number is 120. Now, this for same program, same process, when you enter the number 4, it will show you 24. Result will be 24. So, for any number, for any number, whenever you enter a number, it will show you the factorial of that number within the range. Keep in mind, within the range of integer variable. For example, if you give the value of 8, and the value of a integer is 32,767 to minus 32,768 up to, so like this one. So keep in mind, if your value will be increased from the range of integer variable, it will show you garbage result. Garbage result means it will take any result from the memory and show you. So don't be confused. If you want to the big number factorial of a big number, then you must place long integer over here. Long integer. So keep in mind, for long, L should be small. Long integer will be here. Next program, write a program that reads the coefficient. Write a program that reads the coefficient A, B, and C of the quadratic equation. Quadratic equation. Quadratic, first of all, you must know what is the quadratic equation. So in the mathematics, many times you have performed the quadratic equation. I hope you know the quadratic equation as well. But in this, if this program says, write a program that reads the coefficient A, B, and C. It means that we enter the value of A, value of B, and value of C, and we are going to find out the result, X or X1 or X2. Okay, iostream.h, conio.h. For the next process, we have taken over here maths.h. Next header file is process.h. Why I am using? Because I will use some maths function over here in the program. So I will show you where is the maths function is present. Wide main, float, watch here how many variable A, B, C are the three variable X1, X2, and discriminant. This variable shows the discriminant. So I write the discriminant with the DISC. Clear screen, see out the coefficient. Enter coefficient. So coefficient, first value is A, second value B, third value C. It will read the three values. Now, if I find that discriminant, so discriminant is like this, B square minus 4AC. So I cannot write the B square minus 4AC like we write in the mathematics. How can we write this equation B square minus 4AC? So B multiply by B minus 4 multiply A multiply by C. So all of the variables between, there must be operator between them. So when the discriminant will be known, so if the discriminant is greater than 0, what happened? So X1 should be minus B, where minus B plus square root, this function, built-in function square root. Why I use the math.h? Math.h, the definition of square root function is present in the math.h header file. Okay, it will show, give us the discriminant square root, whole divided by 2 into A. What will be the value of A? It will divide and it will, the result will be stored in the X1. Now this one, because the quadratic equation is like this, minus B plus minus. Now there is plus minus for the quadratic equation, so we cannot use the plus minus for a single. So we will convert into X1 for the plus and X2 for the minus here. Okay, next for the square discriminant, minus B minus square root, same square root function, discriminant. So the next value will be stored in the X2. See how the roots are distinct. The roots are distinct. Exit 0. Now this exit 0, exit is the function built with the process.h, which I use the header file for this function. The definition of exit is present in the process. Now if the discriminant, our discriminant, we will check all the possibilities. We will check all the possibility if the discriminant is equal to 0. What happened if the discriminant is, so it means that X1 equal to X2 is equal to minus B whole divided by 2. So this process will be, so this process will be provide the value to X1 as well as X2. Next, see how the roots are equal. this message will be appear on the screen. X1 is equal to, so value of X1 backslash n, X2 is equal to X2. Now, at the last, we want to display the result. X1 is equal to minus b divided by 2 into a, and the X2 square root plus function discriminant whole divided by 2 into a. Backslash n, the roots are complex. So for the iota values in the quadratic equation, there we should. So all the possibilities we have checked, if the values are minus, then what should be the result? If the value becomes plus, then what should be the result? So this process will be help you to find out the all of your quadratic equation with that program. Whatever the value becomes, or the whatever value you enter for the roots. Roots are A, B, and C. So this one is your next program, which was quadratic equation. The roots are complex. If this message, the first root, X1, iota, this will be added. So you can write with the small I for the iota. This is the message, and X2 will be the result. So over here, you can also use the small I, because iota represent the small I, and X2 will be the display. Get CH, and this one is the closing of the main function. Over here, your chapter number 4 is completed. Whole chapter we have completed, all the things related to the chapter 4 we have done. Even lab activity was your homework, but I know due to the lockdown you are sitting at the home, it was very difficult for you boys to solve at the home and check the errors and again process. But you should practice all of these programs which I have solved in the lecture. You pause your screen, write. If you don't know, first of all, you must try yourself to attempt the program. If you need some kind of help, you can contact with them, with me, or you can also watch the lecture. I hope you are all of you are watching the lecture carefully. So inshallah, from tomorrow we will start the next chapter, which is array. Till take care of yourself. Pray for me, pray for all Muslims. Allah Hafiz.